Hi, my name is Sarah Tariq, and I'm VP of Software at NVIDIA working on autonomous driving. NVIDIA already launched our Drive AV software platform last year, and we've been rapidly expanding its capabilities. We're introducing now full address-to-address driving. That means your car will autonomously drive you along your entire route across highways, interchanges, suburbs, and dense urban traffic. We're going to showcase some of this functionality today in a very typical drive through San Francisco, and I'll talk about some of the software that we've built in order to enable this drive, and also some of the tooling that we're using to allow us to build and validate a safe and very comfortable stack at very large scale. NVIDIA Drive AV is built on top of the Hyperion architecture, which includes a single Drive AGX RN for compute, 10 cameras, 5 radar, and 12 ultrasonics for parking. That's the stack that we're using for L2++ driving, but Hyperion scales all the way from L2++ to L4. For L2++, very importantly, we're not using either LiDAR or HD maps. That makes this a very cost-effective solution and something that you can really put on any consumer car. It also makes our software very scalable across geographies. The software itself is built up of two diverse separate stacks, the classical stack and the end-to-end stack. The classical stack works by perceiving all of the objects in the world, the dynamic objects, classifying them, but also the static objects, bushes, trash cans, so forth, and all of the lane geometry, traffic lights, signs, and so forth. We predict the dynamic objects, what they're going to do in the future, and then we use all of this information along with our route in order to decide what should be the right safe path to follow. On the other side, the end-to-end stack takes the sensors as input, takes the navigation as input, uses a single network in order to produce the final trajectories as output. The final stack then uses both of these trajectories and chooses the safe and comfortable one. What you saw just happen is something very typical for San Francisco or any city. There's people that are double parked all over the place. They might be looking for parking or delivering things. We need to understand that context, that they're double parked, and then very smoothly and safely overtake them, including going into the oncoming lane when needed. Here we have some more stuff going on. This car, you know, just the door is open. This other car, he's reversing. And so when he's reversing, we really want to yield, give him enough space to back up, and then when it's safe to do so, we go around him. In order to build and validate our software at a large scale, we use a number of different simulation technologies. We start with NVIDIA Omniverse, which allows us to create digital twins of the world using all of the sensors that we're getting from our fleet. We use NVIDIA Cosmos to create many different variations of these scenes offline. This can include small variations all the way up to completely changing the scene and creating new ones. This is very important to create large amounts of data for training and validating our stacks, and especially focusing on those edge and rear conditions that we hardly ever see in the real world, but that are nonetheless needed in order to build and validate a very safe, robust stack. So throughout this entire drive, you'll see us behaving very human-like in our driving, and that's because most of the time, the stack that is actually driving, the trajectories that are chosen are the end-to-end ones, and that end-to-end model has learned from countless amounts of human driving data what the right thing to do is that, you know, makes the most sense and is also the smoothest one. So here again, we see this car is reversing, and so we just borrow the oncoming lane to go around it. I mentioned we're not using HD maps, which traditionally is the way most classical AV stacks would build. Instead, what we're doing is we're taking raw camera input and navigation maps like Google Maps as input, and we're creating an online HD map online of the entire world. And what we end up creating then in real time is all of the lane lines, their connectivity, their direction of travel. So that's a right turning lane. This is the lane that goes straight. So we stay here. We understand stop lines, stop signs, whether they're two-way, four-way, traffic lights, and what their rules are, and all of their association. All of this is done within the classical stack in real time. And of course, the end-to-end stack is basically just able to use the sensors and navigation directly. Here we have a pretty complex situation. There's a pedestrian on the right that we're avoiding, and we are also avoiding the oncoming traffic and this very sudden cut-in. Another simulation technology that we're using very heavily is omniverse neural reconstruction, or NUREC for short. NUREC takes camera input and creates 3D reconstruction of the scene. We can then use these 3D reconstructions offline to replay data that we got in the real world with all of the new software that we're creating. And so really we are able to use every mile that we're driving on the road infinite amounts of time to validate every new software release. Because this is a 3D reconstruction and not just a replay of the cameras and sensors, we are able to change things about this replay. For example, every time we are creating new software, the car might decide to do something slightly different, and so it's going to be in a different position. We can now render the scene from this novel point of view. We can also change things about the scene, the actors, insert new ones or change their behaviors. And that allows us to have a really large, robust amount of offline data that we can test our models on before they ever drive in the real world. Today, we are able to do more than 1 million scene reconstructions and test replays a day. And we're going to scale this massively in the coming year. So here we have an unprotected left turn. We can proceed, but only after we yield to cars that are oncoming and also pedestrians that are in our path. And this is just another very typical scene, right? So there's like a double parked vehicle on our right, there's double parked vehicles on our left, and we need to somehow find, when it's safe to do so, enough space to be able to go around this car. In this case, we correctly decide we yield to the oncoming cars, and after that, we can decide to go around him, or in this case, if he moves, we just naturally follow behind him. And in this case, we're nudging around this guy, but if the software decided it didn't want to do that, the human is always able to collaborate with the software, and that's really a feature that is very unique to our software. So, as you can see, we can take over the wheel at any time and collaborate with the software. We can nudge into this oncoming lane and then come back into this lane, let go of the wheel. All the time, the software was still engaged, and it helps you when you're collaborating with it. It takes over completely when you let go. And so that's a really great seamless experience, because you don't have to disengage, do what you want to do, because you might want to do something different, and then re-engage. The software is always engaged. It's always there to help you do the right thing, and then take over when you decide to let go. Thank you for joining me on this drive. We showcase some of the state-of-the-art technology that NVIDIA has been building. It's available in consumer cars, in Mercedes-Benz now, and soon is going to be available on a number of other customer platforms, including Jaguar Land Rover, Lucid, and Stellantis.